buck for just a few days since season. And I got velvet footage of him feeding in the alfalfa field. And then during velvet season, I had a shot at him. I blew the shot. I hit low, hit him in the leg. And so he took off. Never seen the buck for about a week later. Well, it's hard horn season now. And we're out here. And I think I got him patterned down. There's an old hunting shack right over here in front of me. You're gonna see it. It's a hunting shack. They come right by this hunting shack. I got the downwind set. I got buck cage. I'm gonna put it out. I'm gonna hang the cage right there. Got the downwind set. Check this out. This is the buck we're after right here. Downwind scent, people. Extreme apple. We're giving a try. It's late. We're getting ready to get back, set up, and shut up. Let's go. Alright, folks, we're finally settled in. Like I said, we got in here late. Like you've seen us put the buck cage out with the apple attractant, buck coverall in it. You watched us spray the downwind scent all over the place. It's been about 5 minutes right now since we put that out. Got everything settled down. I got the American broadhead right here. Y'all settle in with us. Got a buck. Got a rack buck. Looks like the same buck. Alright, folks, we're back out here the very next morning, and as y'all seen on the footage, that it was getting dark. We got in, set up good, put the downwind scents out. In less than 5 minutes, that buck walked in, smelling. As you seen, he was coming down through, smelling, and he got to an old hunting shack that we had permission to hunt this land. Came up to this old hunt shack, and I made, it was about a 52-yard shot that I made with a bow. He turned and ran towards like a thicket. The thicket branches off into little wig clumps. We did not want to push him, and that was the worst thing you could do is push a deer. And I knew the shot was a little back because he took a step, so I hit him a little low and a little back, so I wanted to give him plenty of time. It's a beautiful 8-point. We've been after this deer, so we kept our eyes out for him, and we started patterning him down again. And once we patterned him down, I knew which way he was coming in. We sat up on him, put the downwind scents out, and captured the shot. Got my arrow here, which is decent blood. I mean, it's dried on it now. It's good blood. The V-Force by Victory. The broadhead, folks. That broadhead, there's nothing done to this broadhead. No damage done whatsoever. We're gonna keep on tracking around. Okay, we made our way through this, as you can see, this thicket back here. Get the camera now, show you a little bit of this thicket. It's actually like a cut over. And it's just grown up. That's what he ran to. And I come right down here. Folks, he's laying right here in this ditch. And this is an ending to a good success. Put your scents, your scent dispenser, your good bow, which is my quest. a good straight arrow by V-Force and the good short broadhead by American Broadhead Company is your ticket to success. So join in, join us, and have a little fun. I'm Steve Swartz.